How do you think about science v. technology in developing new cancer medicines?
Yeah, thank you. Look, at GSK, we see our mission at the intersection of science and technology, as you've described. And a great example of that is functional genomics. It's generating vast amounts of data to describe the disease, if you like, to generate the evidence, so we can unlock new insights that will have a positive impact on cancer research and treatment. Now, within that, artificial intelligence is essential to interpret those data and help point the way. This will build a new bridge between the laboratory and the clinic. I call this digitization of biology. Now, Fyodor, perhaps you might tell us just a little more about how CRISPR fits into this story. How are we using it to improve the search for new oncology medicines in general at the LGR?
If you continue to think about cancer as a crime against our DNA, then step one, of course, is to gather all the evidence. And CRISPR is an extraordinary magnifying glass. It allows us to zoom in on literally individual letters in our genetic code, both in normal cells and cancer cells, and track down the full information set, if you will, about what drove a particular normal cell to change its DNA and then become cancerous. Okay, well, you've gathered the evidence, so now what? Well, you basically need the modern-day equivalent of a Sherlock Holmes-like intelligence to filter, parse through all of that to get to actionable information. And this, of course, is where artificial intelligence comes in. We can't rebuild Sherlock Holmes, but we can, on some level, do better because computers, as we've learned, can be oftentimes a lot more powerful than any individual human mind. I'm excited for the fact that the Laboratory of Genomics Research can bring it all together in the same space to do this one-of-a-kind, first-ever DNA sleuthing to get to the sources of cancer and understand how to treat it better.